Gracious Word, presented by Church of Christ.
Dear beloved friends and School of Evangelism students, greetings to you all. A small devotion during this time. God has revealed His Word, that is called Bible. If you want to reach the heaven, Jesus said, He is the way. In order to know His way, we should search and research His words. So, in order to do the proper search of the Word of God, just I would like to give you some points for your meditation. Right attitude in Bible study. In 1 Corinthians 3, 1-3, it very clearly says, For until now you were not able to receive it, and even now you are still not able, for you are still carnal. We should have a right attitude when we do the search of the Word of God. For your cross-reference, you can read 2 Peter 3:18, Grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hebrews 5:12, For though by this time you ought to be a teacher, you need someone to teach you again the first principles of the oracles of God. So, there must be a right attitude to develop ourselves to be the teacher of the Word of God. What kind of attitudes are needed? Point 1. Love the truth or love the Bible. Daily, a minute you pray to God in the name of Jesus, God develop a mind or attitude to have a thirst or a love towards your word. Psalm 119:97. Oh, how I love your law. So develop an attitude to love the truth or the word of God. 2 Thessalonians 2:10-12, you can read more. Point 2. The right attitude. Have a faith. Without faith, if you read or search the Word of God, it is used for nothing. Faith produces a result, a profit. Hebrews 11:6, Romans 10:17. Would you like to receive a reward from God? Have a faith on the Word of God and have a faith on God. Deuteronomy 29:29. So develop attitude to love and have a faith in the Word of God. Romans 8:28. All things work together for good to those who love God. Point 3. Use common sense. The purpose of the Bible, to know about God, to know about the salvation, to know about Jesus Christ, to know about the heaven and the hell, to know about the Father in heaven. So this kind of common sense we must have when we read the Bible. Be diligent, the next point. Romans 12:11, 2 Timothy 2:15. The next point, respect the Bible. Respect, when we respect somebody, something, we obey it. And whenever you read a word, try to understand how to apply and obey to that word. 6. Expect to understand. John 8:32. You shall know the truth will set you free. Ephesians 3:3-5. Make known thy mystery, as I wrote before in few words. 2 Peter 1:20-21. So, we must have an attitude to understand that. So try to develop attitude to have a Bible study. Bible reading is different. Bible memorizing is different. Bible study, search is different. Search will bring us eternal life. Thank you for your patience. Thank you. God bless you. Bye.
Dear friends, I greet you all in the living Lord Jesus Christ's name and welcome you to this Gracious Word Bible Study English program. Our dedication towards this program is to follow the Bible and study the Bible in a systematic way and search the scriptures as the Bereans did, and they were called as fair-minded people. Today, our meditation verse will be, our Bible study verse will be from Genesis chapter 4 verse 9. Here it tells like this: Then the Lord said to Cain, "Where is Abel your brother?" He said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper?" My beloved people, God asked a simple question to Cain, but since Cain killed Abel and he had an enmity between him and his brother, his answer was something a rude one. If he has said, "I do not know," that's a simple answer, but he added, "Am I my brother's keeper?" Today we are going to meditate or study from this phrase, "Am I my brother's keeper?" What the God expects from us. Cain's answer may be, "Am I my brother's keeper?" But the Lord God expects everyone inside his family to be the keeper of their brothers and sisters. That is, we have to care for their souls. In this selfish world, we have some good lessons to learn today from this scripture. We have to care for our brothers and sisters inside the family and inside the church. Here are some points to consider. The first one would be, we have to watch for their souls. Here is a verse which tells like this, Hebrews chapter 13 verse 17, "Obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch out for your souls as those who must give account. Let them do so with joy and not with grief, for that would be unprofitable for you." My beloved people, my beloved brothers and sisters, inside the church, we have leaders like preachers and elders who are to watch out for our souls. The Bible clearly tells like this. So they have to care for their brothers inside the church. So the leaders are to watch out for the souls of the members, and the members are expected to allow those leaders to fulfill their duty to perform with joy and not with grief. My beloved people, the second thing we like to study from this verse is, spiritual people must do the restoration work. First one, yes, we are to care for our brothers. So we have to watch out for their souls as the leaders has to do with the members of the church. The second thing is, we are studying, spiritual people must do the restoring. Yeah, when our brothers and sisters are falling away from the grace of God, when they are caught in sins, we cannot be reckless, we cannot just neglect them, let them go away. But the Bible clearly tells that we have to restore them. Let us read Galatians chapter 6 verse 1. "Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted." When our brothers and sisters in the God's family, they are caught in sins and they are falling away from the grace of God, we have to restore them from that. What spirit we have to have? The Bible tells in this verse, we have to have a spirit of gentleness. We cannot be rude on them. We cannot put them in shame. But we have to restore them from the sins, from the worldly activities, and make them spiritual people and restore them to be children of God with the spirit of gentleness. The third thing we'll discuss is, we have to bear their infirmities. We have to bear the infirmities of the weak. Romans chapter 15 verse 1 tells like this, "We then who are strong ought to bear with the scruples of the weak and not to please ourselves." We cannot live a selfish life. We cannot say, "I am holy, I am going to heaven." I don't care about anyone. We have to bear the infirmities of the weak. Bearing the infirmities of the weak is a nature of Jesus Christ. And we have to follow that pattern. Being like Jesus Christ, we have to bear the infirmities of the weak. Remember what Jesus did in this world? He was just doing that only, all the time. He was bearing the infirmities of the weak. He was healing people. He was kind to them. He was restoring them to the family of God. So we have to be like that one. The fourth one is, we have to bear one another's burdens. We have to bear the one another's burdens. Galatians chapter 6 verse 2 says, bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. It's a law of Christ. When we want to fulfill the law of Christ, we have to bear one another's burden. Sometimes we think like this, being holy is having a good relationship with God only. Myself and my God, we are okay, just okay, I am going to heaven. No, it's a triangle relationship. Myself, my God and my brothers and sisters. This triangle must be perfect. So here the Bible tells, bear one another's burdens and fulfill the law of Christ. It's a law of Christ, we have to bear one another's burden. The fifth one and the last one I'd like to share with you is regarding that phrase, am I my brother's keeper? And he's saying to us today that yes, we are to keep our brothers and sisters. And the fifth one is, we have to want, comfort, support and be patient with them. We have to want them, we have to comfort them, we have to support them and we have to be patient with them. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 14 tells like this, now we exhort you brethren, warn those who are unruly, comfort the faint hearted, uphold the weak, be patient with all. The children of God can never be with enmity to anybody, any human being. He has to warn those who are unruly, comfort the faint hearted, uphold the weak and be patient with everyone. So this is what we have been commanded by our Lord God in relationship with our brothers and sisters, inside the family it may be or inside the church. So let us fulfill the law of Christ. Let us care for the souls of our brothers and sisters and let us love them as Jesus loved them. My beloved brothers and sisters, this is what we have seen today from this message. We have to watch for the souls of our brothers and sisters. We have to restore them. As a spiritual people, we have to restore them. The third one, we have to bear their infirmities. When they are weak, we have to bear their infirmities. And the fourth one, we have seen that we have to bear one another's burden. We have to bear the burden of our brothers and sisters. And the fifth one, we have to warn them, comfort them, we have to support them, and we have to be patient with all. When we do this one, our God will be a loving God to us as we are loving our brothers and sisters. May the grace of God and peace of Christ be with you all. Amen.
Be blessed by studying the Word of God. To receive the Voice of Truth International magazine and to study the Bible systematically through our English Bible Correspondent course, kindly write to us. Our address, Gracious Word, P.O. Box 15, Arasradi, Madurai, 625016, Tamil Nadu. For more details, dial 9244204420, 9244214421. God bless you.
The Church of Christ salutes you.
Joy Creative Production.
For video coverage and editing, audio recording and editing, promo for advertisement, graphic design.
Contact 9042494996.